God bless you. I am Dr. Dayo Sowale. I'll be talking to you about digitalization today. Yes. Now, in the digital world, you see that the first assignment I have today is to make you see digitalization the way it is. If you look at what I have here on the screen, you see, if you can see the screen very well, you can see a man working on someone's brain. You can see this person trying to remove something and adding something into the person's brain. Do you know what that is telling us? That is telling us that there is something for you to offer. There is something for you to give. You understand? And what you, sorry, sir, I could not hear you when you said what you said before the break. I didn't say anything. I didn't say anything before the break. I was only trying to bring this together. I've just started the class. You understand? Thank you. So now, what I'm saying, my duty now is to help you understand. That's why I put this picture there. You have to, everything you had in mind about digitalization, I'm going to remove it and put what should be there for you. That's my duty. Are you getting it? And that's exactly what I am set to do. What you had in mind that is wrong, what you had in mind that shouldn't be, I'm going to remove it. What's the truth about digitalization? It's not your feeling, it's not your ideology, it's just what exactly it is. And that is what we want to be looking at today. Now, by the time, let's start with the definition. Digitalization is the new normal. Of course, it's no more news that we had that there was a pandemic attack, which is still ongoing, ravaging. So, we had a short break there. So, I said that it's ravaging the world. Now, when you talk about digitalization, it's the new normal. Now, the old normal, everybody knows, is the formatting we had. You understand? That's the old normal. Everybody knows the old normal is what we used to have. I mean, you know the old normal, the way we do things in the physical world, in the analog world, that's the old normal. Now there's a new normal, there is a change, there is a move from what we used to have to what we are, to what we now have. That change, that new normal is digitalization. That new thing that everybody must run after. That new thing that everybody must follow is now what we call digitalization. Are you getting me now? So digitalization is the new normal. What's the other definition of digitalization? It's the conversion of text, of pictures, or sound into a digital form that can be processed by a computer system. Digitalization converts assets to a digital format. Apart from that, it makes it easier to store, to share, manage, and analyze data. That's something that is very important about digitalization. Digitalization makes it very easy for you to share data. It makes it easy for you to manage data and to analyze data. That's one of the things digitalization does. Digitalization will help you to put together your assets, everything you have. You put everything together. And of course, what is digitalization? Oh, it's a shift. It's a movement. You know, there's something we call a paradigm shift. Those of us who are into psychology and generally in academics, we say that we need a paradigm shift. Digitalization is a shift. It's a movement from physical into the digital form, from the physical world, from everything we used to do in the physical into the digital and online form. I want you to now begin to listen. There's something important there. Digitalization provides a platform. Are you with me? To convey your content to the countries. Now, if you look at this, does that give you any ideology of what digitalization does? It provides you a platform, a means, a method, a mode for you to convey, to carry your content to the countries. When you have your content, you have what you believe in, you have everything, digitalization provides you a platform, a means, so that through digitalization, you can convey whatsoever you have as your content to the countries. You see, everything you add in ab initio has been limited to your compound. We are moving you from your compound to the countries. Everything, all your content has been limited to your compound. Now we are moving you from the compound to the countries. How do we do that? Through digitalization. So when we talk about digitalization, it's just providing you a platform so that that content you carry will be taken away from the container of your compound and it will be released to the countries. I want you to begin to reason about what digitalization is. The reason why most people will tell you, wow, so this is what digitalization is. The reason is because they later get to understand that digitalization is actually not what they thought it's expected to be. One of the things digitalization does in this age of ours is to ensure that what you carry, your content, what you are, what you know, mean, the things you have been doing for years that has been limited to your compound, that has been limited to a container of your organization, that has been limited to your church, that has been limited to your mosque, that has been limited to your area where you are. Digitalization will now help you to convey those content, will help you to carry those things you have to where? To the countries. Digitalization doesn't stop there. When it goes to the countries, then digitalization has something to do. It provides you a platform to promote your potentials to the people. Digitalization provides you a platform to promote your potentials, what you have. It promotes it to the people. That means the gifting, the strength, the things you know, digitization will help you to carry to the people. You know, a lot of people don't know what digitization does. A lot of people don't know how digitization applies to them, but now you are going to be learning it. Those potentials that you have that have been limited in your area, that have been limited wherever you are living, in your place of work, digitization helps you to promote it. It helps you to carry it. Your potentials will now be carried to where? To the people. You know, the people want to hear you. They want to know, what do you carry? Can you see the way we are communicating now? I know these things. I've known it for years. If not for digitization, how will I meet you? How am I going to communicate with you? I remember in one of the classes we had people from France, from Canada, USA, and Dubai connecting. You understand? And of course, they're in class. I just finished a class now on blogging. And in that class, we have people from outside the country, from Canada, be part of the class. How would I have been able to get such people if not through digitalization? So digitalization gives you a platform to promote your potentials to the people. So instead of your potentials being limited to your area, instead of your potentials being limited to your precinct, to your own particular place, it will not be taken to the people. It brings to fore. That means it brings out. It brings to fore the ability and skills of the person. It brings out the ability and skills of the person. It protects something that digitalization cannot do. And that's what we are getting into. Digitalization, however, cannot promote that which is lacking in the individual. Do you get that point? What you don't have, you can't give. Nemo dat quod non habet. That's what the lawyers will tell us. You understand? What you don't have, you can't give. Digitalization cannot promote that which is lacking in the individual. What does that mean? It means that digitalization will showcase mental capacity. So your mental capacity, digitalization will show it. It will reveal it to us. If any one of you has been following me, you must have been reading my blog. You must have been reading my blog. Digitalization, everything I'm writing, it's not this world that is now, it's not digitalization that is writing those things for me, but it's digitalization that is helping me to promote those things. Am I communicating? Digitalization showcase, it showcases mental capacity, but it cannot fill the gap of mental deficiency. You see that? So if there is mental deficiency, if there is something you cannot get, there's something you don't understand, there's something you don't know, it's not as if digitalization will now come and now begin to teach you those things. No, it will not teach you. Digitalization will only help you to promote that which you know. It will only help you to bring forth that which is very clear to you. What you don't have, you don't have. So it showcases your mental capacity, but it cannot fill the mental deficiency. Now, it cannot be a cover-up for inadequacies. Are you getting that? Digitalization doesn't cover up. Is going to expose everything. We are saying that your content is leaving your compound and going to the countries. That's what digitalization does. That's all. It cannot be a cover up for inadequacies, inefficiency, and incapacity. You cannot give what you don't have. So when we talk about digitalization, you will discover that a lot of people don't understand what digitalization is. And that's why you are in class today, to understand that what's the concept of digitalization. What exactly does it mean? When we talk of digitalization, some people say, no, I don't know how to use the computer. We are not talking about computer literacy. Digitalization goes beyond computer literacy. You understand? It's talking about you being announced to the world. It's talking about your potential going to the people. It's talking about you are seated where you are now, and everywhere in the world, there is a contact, there is a call coming to your table. That's digitalization. So what you lack, digitalization cannot give. Nemo dat. Now let me show you this diagrammatically. Diagrammatically, you see this? Can you see this young man? He's going inside the fold. I always say this jokingly that in the past years, those of us who are in the lecturing program, in academics, we always tell our students, look, don't disturb my class with phone. Don't bring phone to the class. You know what has happened now? The class has gone inside the phone. You understand? That's digitalization. The class itself has left. There is no student for you to tell now not to bring class into the phone, because if you are looking for the class now, it's inside the phone. You remember the years when we always say, respect the house of God. You don't bring church in. Now the church is in the phone. That's what we are talking about. So you look at it, digitalization, you are getting inside that phone. And you see what that guy, this young man did? He's getting inside the phone. You are getting inside that phone. That is digitalization. So you see this young boy is meditating, mental capacity, he's focusing. You see this aspect. So when you talk of digitalization, it talks more about your mental capacity than your computer literacy. That's why if you are in academics, with due respect to those who are not, but 90% of us in the house today, we are in the academia. If you're in academics, you must, as a matter of fact, you must get involved with digitalization. Because in academics, it's when you fully understand what it means, you will fully understand how it's going in the digital world. In academics, you have something to sell. The capacity is there. But that capacity is only limited to where you publish. The journals is only limited to the conferences. There are some people that are not in academics. They want to gain from your wealth of experience. How do they get you? It's through digitalization. And that's why you are in class. Let's look at the features of digitalization. What are its features? One, it's universal. It covers the world without boundaries. Digitalization will tear the boundaries. It tears the container and it tears the fence of your compound. Digitalization is what takes you. We carry your content from your compound and takes it to the countries. That's digitalization. If you tear the fence, if you tear everything that is limiting you, if you tear everything that is disturbing you from growing to everywhere you need to get to, digitalization, it covers the world without boundaries. That's it. Then it has endless possibilities. You know, I've said this times and again, that there are some calls I've received that if not for digitalization, I would not have received. Even you here, a good 80% of those of you in the house now, if not for digitalization, you won't be here. Because I don't even know some people. Are you getting it now? So that's what we call digitalization. And that is exactly what we are referring to. So in the digital world, you see that what we talk about in terms of digitalization is it's endless possibilities. Someone will just check your LinkedIn page. Like I'll be able to pick you up and tell you, okay, we are giving you this assignment. Well, it's not only because you are on LinkedIn, but because you are rightly connected, there are ways to write on it. There are ways to put things together, and that's digitalization. Another feature of digitalization, another property is that it is procedural. What do you mean by procedural? Digitalization is procedural because it requires various training. You don't just jump into it. There are laid down rules you are going to follow. There are things we call SEO, SERPs, SEO search engine optimization. You understand? All these things are there, and that's why you are in class today. You see, even after today's class, you begin to discover some new things about digitalization. Then by the time we'll be finishing on Sunday, wow, when you see what it means in the digital world, you will actually understand it's for computer literacy. Specialization, now that's where we are going. You create a niche. Can I give an assignment in the class? Go to your chat room and help me type a niche, because I'm going to be explaining that. Create a niche. Go to the chat room. Let me be sure you are with me. Create a niche in the digital world. The first thing and about the most important thing there is that you have to create a niche. You must have a place that you call your own. You must have what we call a niche. We call your own area of specialty. You must have something that it is you. I wish I could see you write that niche. Let me see that. I've not seen anybody writing. Go to the chat room and write niche. You create a niche. Create a niche. You must have a niche. Which area? You cannot be in every area. Oh, you are a lawyer? Which area of law are you? Are you specializing on? You understand? Okay, some people are writing. Thank you so much. Create a niche. Like, I'm grateful. Oye Kachi, God bless you. Ronke, thank you so much. Create a niche. You create a niche. You must create a niche, an area of specialty, the area that you can call your own. And my humble self now, when you say legal writing, thank you so much. I love that. My learned senior, I appreciate that so much. Legal writing, that's an age. That's an age. But it goes beyond that. Like my uncle said now, I have my PhD in computer engineering before I went into law. So by the time you look at it, what's my need? I'm talking about digitization. I'm talking about intellectual property. My senior friend will understand me very well. You understand? Apart from that, I am a motivational speaker. I talk about personal development. You create a niche, the area that you call your own. You create a niche, the area that is peculiar to you. You create a niche. When they mention that area, they call you. Now, if you look at the niche I have created in the world, I've created a niche in the area of mentality and reality. That's why you see that I'm always writing in that regard. If you read my work, you see me talking about mentality, talking about reality. You need a niche. Now, you adults in the house, those of us who have grown up in the house more than the younger ones, are you now realizing that digitalization, it goes beyond what you leave to the children? They're going to see more of it. You create a niche, you must have one. I will still be repeating that. It's very important. A niche, if you don't understand yourself, you cannot create a niche. If you don't understand your giftings, you don't understand your potentials, you don't understand your area of peculiarity, you cannot create a niche. Look at my senior friend who is talking about legal writing, for example. A lot of us want to learn about legal writing. The question is, the things you know about legal writing, how can we assess them? We are not talking of the journals published for promotion. No, by the time you have that representation in the digital world, oh wow. And people like us will now come on that, we see it. Then when they mention legal writing, Google will refer to you. When they mention legal writing, everybody will point to you because you have blocked that area. That's a slang I use. If you block it, you block it. If you block an area, you block that area. So anytime they talk about that area, it is you and nobody else. And that's what we are looking at. Create an age. What are the features of digitalization? You think value not activities. Oh, the era of 30 days make one pay is gone. Nobody's going to be doing that again. People will now pay you for your activity, your performance, how good are you? That's what they're going to be paying on. It's no more 30 days, one pay. Those things, they are not there again. That's why you are saying, Oshiba, you said something yesterday or 2 days ago, that a lot of Nigerians will be poor. I laughed. Nigerians don't need to be poor. Nobody needs to lose job with digitalization. There are numerous opportunities. They want content developers. They want bloggers. They want people who can do voiceover artists. They want a lot of things. A lot of people want people who will do design. You see, there is no reason why people should go poor. There is no reason why people should go jobless with this era of digitalization. But what do we pay for? We pay for value. We are not going to pay for I came to work today. We pay for what you did. Not your coming. No. Your coming is irrelevant. It's your doing that you attract things. So you think value, not activities. Physical disability is no more the limitation, but rather mental disability. Can you see that? Let me ask a question and I want an answer. What is the limitation of digitalization? Please, what is the limitation of digitalization? Your set is the first set. I'll be asking questions in that regard. What is the limitation of digitalization? I want an answer. I want it to be very fast. What's the limitation of digitalization? Digitalization has a limitation. What is it? Yeah. Someone is answering me. Yeah. No. The limitation of digitalization is on the board. You are seeing it. Just go through it, my professor. Just go through it. The limitation of digitalization. Yeah, you get it. It's there with you. Limitation of digitalization. What exactly is it? Something limits us in the digital world. What's the limitation of digitalization? I want to read from you. Yes, someone else. Mental disability. That is it. That's the limitation. The limitation is mental disability. It's good you are streaming. Please be following. Usually I'm fast when we are doing this Zoom meeting. By the time you get to higher classes, I'm going to reduce my speed. Do you understand? I want you to learn, and that's why I'm so sorry. You get it? The limitation of digitalization is mental disability. Can you see that? I said here that physical disability is no more the limitation, but rather mental disability. You know, in the physical world, if someone is physically disabled, that person cannot function well. But in the digital world, even if you are lame, you will function well. If you are blind, you function well. But if you are mentally disabled, the mental disability is not madness. It's low mentality in the things we do. Some people cannot write on the issue of rape. What can you write? That's the question. What can you write? Rape is trending now. If you are going to be writing what everybody on the street is saying, then you don't need to write anything because it's not going to be relevant. Are you getting it? Digitalization goes beyond that. Mental disability is the limitation of digitalization. The depth, your mental depth will determine your height in the digital world. The most important tool in digitalization, what is it? Can everybody type it? The most important tool, what you need most in digitalization, can someone type it? I want to read from you, everybody. The most important tool in digitalization, that shows you are learning now, that shows you are getting it. Because before this class, if you are asked for digitalization, you will think it's computing. What's the most important tool? I want someone to type. I want to read from you. The most important tool in digitalization is what? Yeah, the most important tool, intelligence. Thank you, my professor. The most important tool is intelligence. Is intelligence. Can I read from others? The most important tool. Now, do you now begin to see that once you have intelligence, you are qualified? Once you have intelligence, that's why I listen to my voice note. I say, become a digital pastor, become a digital lecturer, become a digital lawyer, become a digital imam, whatsoever, become a digital doctor, a digital nurse, anything you are, you digitalize it. What are you digitalizing? It's not intelligence. Are you getting it? So when you lack intelligence, there is nothing you are coming to do in the digital world. Now, who lacks intelligence here? Of course, nobody. If you lack intelligence, you won't be in the class. That means already you have what it takes. Are you getting it? Don't get yourself discouraged. No, no, never. Don't get yourself discouraged. So you see that intelligence is the most important tool. Ability to provide solutions to apparent demand or needs. Now, something important is originality. Everybody, help me type originality. I'm going to explain it. Thank you so much. Help me type originality. I'm explaining that right away. I want to be sure you are typing it. Yeah, originality. What's originality? Originality is talking about no room for copycats. Be you. Do you know what Google is going to pay you for? They will pay you for originality. Google will pay you for being you. That's it. Originality. Google will pay you for being you. And that is something you have to understand. That's something that has to guide you. And that's something you have to follow. Google will pay you for being you. Originality. Please try and understand this idea of originality. Originality is when you don't fake yourself. Where are you good at? Do you understand? Once you get it, a lot of people, let me tell you the reason why the people in the entertainment world now, the reason why they are not having problem in the digital world is because most of them are not original. They keep repeating things, they keep forwarding the same thing. You understand? This one will talk like this, that one will talk like this other one, and Google is not going to rate you when you are a copycat. So in the digital world, copycats are not allowed. Originality is what we promote. Originality, be original. Thank you so much, my engineer Dipong. Thank you so much, Alani. God bless you. You should be original. Now, what are the myths about digitalization? The things you have been told, which are never the truth. Now, number one, some people say, oh, you must be computer literate. It's not true, sir. It's not true, man. That you must be computer literate. No, it's not true. That you don't need to be, if you are, there are some aspects when we get there, you know, that you can talk of the computer literacy being needed. Some will say it is for youth. No, probably it's not meant for youth alone. It's meant for everybody. Digitalization is meant for, and from what we are saying now, how many youths have the capacity, the intelligence and mental capacity that you have, you are adult. You understand? So digitalization is not only meant for youth, it's meant for everybody. Then some people will tell you it is free. No, digitalization is not free. When they come with that style, they tell you, oh, it's free. Come and do this. No, there is something else that you is not free. They might need you to be part of their traffic. It's not free. You are going to pay something. And that's why I'm always careful. Now, by that, you tell people, look at where you are here now. We have been calling some people, join us, don't join us. It's such. Why? Because they have paid an amount of money. So digitalization is never free. Some people tell you it gives quick money. Forget it. It doesn't give quick money. Digitalization takes a process and it doesn't give quick money. Now, these are the myths. What are the facts about digitalization? One, it requires personal discovery. Can you imagine that this is a fact about digitalization? Digitalization requires personal discovery. You know, is it not funny? If I'm telling you that one of the most important things about digitalization is that it requires personal discovery. You understand? So digitalization requires personal discovery. It shows you that you have to go beyond the usual thing. If you don't know yourself, you cannot function, you can't go far in the digital world. The digital world requires some level of consistency. If you don't know yourself, who you are, you can't go far. You must know who you are for you to go far in the digital world. The digital world requires personal discovery because it is what you have discovered that you are going to display. Is someone listening to me? It's what you have discovered that you are going to display. That's something very, very important. That's something very important. It's what you have discovered that you are going to display. If you don't discover it, you cannot display it. You have to discover who you are. You have to understand who you are before you can begin to display who exactly you are. And that is what digitalization is all about. Apart from that, you discover that in the digital world, you also need to understand this aspect. That is, your height depends on the depth of your mental capacity. Can someone help me type that word? Mental capacity. Your height depends on your mental capacity. Just help me type it. Mental capacity. It is important. Mental capacity. Your height depends on your mental capacity. Because if how high you go, yes. Is someone typing that for me? Thank you so much, Mrs. Kolawole. It depends on your mental capacity. Yeah, mental capacity. I'm enjoying that. Mental capacity. You see, please help me type it. Help me type it. Mental capacity. Because if you don't have that mental capacity, if you don't have it working for you, oh, then you have not gotten exactly what you are supposed to get. You understand? So those are the things you need to understand in terms of digitalization. It requires mental capacity. I'm happy. I'm reading it. My okay, I've not read from you. Mr. Aluko, I'm here to read from you. You understand? So you see that it requires mental capacity, and this is something that is very important. This is something that is germane, mental capacity. A lot of people don't understand that these are the basic things required by digitalization. They don't understand that these are the things that digitalization really requires. All they think is, oh, digitalization is about computer literacy. What they think is digitalization is about what computer are you using and what have you. No, digitalization goes beyond that. Digitalization requires mental capacity. So when you increase your mental capacity, you discover that you have a lot of things that will be working on for you, a lot of things that will be working positively for you. The next thing is that it must be purpose-oriented. Now, before I go to purpose-oriented, let me explain something about mental capacity. Give me a minute, please. Thank you. So now, by the time you look at it, I'm going to talk about mental capacity. Mental capacity is your ability to reason and put things down. Please, from those, you know, 8.0 means that you are the eighth set. From the first seven sets, about we now have two sets taking block. What I've experienced about them, mental capacity is an issue. You see, some of them, by the time they write, you don't have problem. Some cannot even write. It's not as if they don't want to write. To put down their thoughts is a challenge. So when I'm telling you that your height in the digital world depends on the depth of your mental capacity. And that's why everything I emphasize, you should take note of it. Another issue, my brothers and sisters, is that you must be purpose-oriented. Why are you coming into digitalization? One of the reasons why you can come to digitalization is, one of the reasons is that you want to make name. Take, for example, in your field, like my senior friend who spoke about legal writing. In legal writing, when they write legal writing anywhere in the world, we want that name to come up, Dr. Barrister Latif, Alamu Latif. We want that name to come up. So that is relevance. Are you getting it? And once you have relevance, you are going to have money. Because you must be purpose-oriented. You have relevance. From relevance, then you have money. But money will not precede relevance. No. Because what they are going to pay you, they are going to pay you when they discover that you are truly having relevance and you are making progress. Are you getting it now? So it must be purpose-oriented. Then it requires traffic. What do you mean by traffic? We are saying that people will follow you. You need people to follow you. You need people to be with you, because it cannot just happen overnight. Digitalization requires traffic. Those of us who are lecturers, we have this. I will show you how people make money in the digital world. It's so funny. You know that all your students are your traffic. Google will not know that they are your students. If you write a blog, for example, and you tell your students to go and read what you wrote, and they should give you a report the next time you are meeting. Each time they open it, Google will be counting it that you have traffic, and it's on that basis that Google will pay you through Google AdSense. Do you understand what I'm talking about? So digitalization requires traffic. Then it requires patience. You have to be patient. You can't rush. You can't rush. I started writing some things in blog some weeks back. Today now, I now have over 6,000 readers that have gone through my blog. Do you understand? So you have to be patient. You grow it. You don't eat it at a time. You grow it. It's gradual. You have to be patient. So digitalization requires patience. You have to understand that. It's not going to happen overnight. Boom. No, it requires patience. Now, let's look at the categories of digitalization. I believe you are in class, you are learning. Normally, at this time, I usually take a break. You understand? But for now, I won't take a break. I'll keep moving. Categories of digital participants. When you talk about digitalization, there are categories. There are some people called digital masses. Who are they? What do they do? Digital masses, everybody. Everybody in the world. No, digitalization is like a marketplace. Everybody is free to go to the market. Some people don't have shop, they have nothing to buy, they have nothing to sell, they just be walking around. These are people we call digital masses. These are the people, no training is needed. They don't make money in the digital world. They just waste their data. They are always on WhatsApp, downloading music, downloading films, and that's all they do. They burn data unnecessarily. They forward video that they don't know the source, they can't explain the content, they just read and forward me. Even in the digitalization class, there's a class we organized, free class. I was working yesterday night and I saw one of the people there posted something. And the man said, I am so. He mentioned his name. The next thing is that, please, I'm prophet so. Forward this to 7 people. And he said, oh, God will bless you. I don't know who to slap, if it is the poster or the posted. You understand? So it's so annoying. Those are digital masses. He has posted that. Now the question is, what did the man say? The man is saying that you have enemies everywhere. In 7 hours, they will be gone. Just forward it. I'm going to pray for you. Within 7 hours, you now ask yourself, what is this man saying? The person who posted it, what came to his brain before he posted it? Those are people with digital masses. They don't make any money in the digital world. They waste time. That's what they do. Their digital masses, limited. So everybody, Iruwa masses. You understand? Those are people who call digital masses. And that's what they are. Little or no training. No training is needed. No training. They just pick the phone. If you see them, they are playing games. If you see them, it's not games to relax. It's just to waste time. You understand? We call them digital masses. Then we have the digital workers. Who are the digital workers? This category trades products and services in the digital world. Everybody in this class is qualified to be a digital worker, because that's why you are here, you are learning. They have a digital presence and digital value. You'll be tomorrow, or Sunday rather, you'll be learning about digital value and digital presence. They spent and they earn. Oh, can you imagine? You have spent, now definitely you are going to earn compulsory in the digital world. Now look at me, I am earning now. How am I earning? I'm earning because through this digitalization, I'm able to tell you this. And once I tell you this, you discover that I am earning because, of course, you are paying me. But also, I'm spending. I paid Zoom. You didn't pay Zoom. You understand? I have to pay before I can have this long-ass connection. So that is what we are talking about. The digital workers, they work, they make money. And that is the category you should belong. I always say this, don't do for fun what others are doing for fun. Some people are doing some things for fun. Maybe I should write that for you. You should not do it for fun. What others are doing for fun. You look at it. Don't do for fun what others are doing for fun. Can you see the two now? For fun? No, you are wasting time. Others are doing it for fun. They are making money. You are wasting time with the phone. Some people are making money with that same phone. Look at what you have learned so far. Since you have started this plan, that is what your phone is meant for. In the digital world, maximize yourself. That is the difference between efficiency and effectiveness. You have to maximize yourself. Then, of course, we have the digital vendors. And now, the spend and hair requires training, of course. You need to be trained to maximize any. Digital vendors, this category of people, what they just do, they are middlemen. They are not programmers. They will go to those who need digital products, maybe someone who needs solution on e-learning and the rest, they will speak to that person. When they speak to the person, the person will design for them. I'm a digital developer. I'm a programmer, for example. I develop applications, I develop blogs, I develop websites, I develop portals. Maybe you can come to me and tell me, oh, doctor, help me to design this for this school. Then you will collect Y money from me. You will now collect X plus Y from them. Where X must be greater than zero. Do you understand? So you are a digital vendor. You are still making money. It's better than we are digital innovators. These are not really common in Nigeria. These people are those who will sit down. They are analysts. They are strategists. They will sit down and tell you this is how the company should go, and they will make a lot of prediction, a lot of suggestion, which we see the company through. Then we have categories of digital workers. Categories of digital workers. Now, what are they? Okay, sorry, before we go to categories, we have categories of digital masses and the digital gap. We want to look at the people generally in the digital world. Of course, we have three categories. We have digital natives, our very young brothers and sisters from age 0 to 29. They are digital natives. They are born into the digital world. I know that some of us, Dr. Latif, Engineer Alani, and my big brother, Engineer Aluko, most of us here, we understand that when we were in school, there was nothing like phone. I remember that I would leave Lagos to come to OAU. The only reason why I've traveled that far, you know the only reason? To confirm if OAU has resumed. Can you imagine? And when I would get there, oh, they said we are still on strike. I will now go back again. Your parents will tell you, you have to go so that you can find out. You will not be happy staying at home because you want to know. And today now, that's the digital natives. As a lecturer, at times it becomes funny. A student will call you and ask you, sir, have we resumed? You now keep wondering, what do these students mean? You will think of your own days. Where is the phone for you to call your prof? That's, have you resumed? But you know, these are digital natives. They are children. They are youth. Usually, they have nothing to offer in the digital world. They have little or nothing to contribute. But you know the funny thing? They are the heavy users. They are the ones always online. They are the ones always there. They resort to games, to music, very painful at times, pornography. And that is telling on the society now with this issue of increasing rape, etc. When there is nothing else to browse, they misuse and abuse digitalization. What should they have done? They should have learned designs, blog designs, website designs, and they should have learned programming. They are the digital natives. They are born into this thing. It's part of them. So they shouldn't be wasting time. If you have anybody who is in this category here, I want to advise you that you have everything to learn programming. Go ahead and learn it and become professional at it. Digital immigrant, this is where most of us belong. The middle age, we learned it. We were not born with it. No, we were not born with it. The person that did my naming ceremony was not called on phone. You know what I'm talking about. It's not the one that you want to name a child. The person will send the text message, I'm on my way. There's no chance for that. These ones are immigrants. When they were born, there was nothing like digitalization as we have it today. So middle age learned it. They saw the necessity and they adapted. But of course, they lack the in-depth knowledge. No, you don't know as much as these people know. You understand? As these people know, rather. Usually, what we now find out is that this category of people are restricted to applications. that are relevant to their jobs or the purposes for which they have led. They are weak at exploring. Thereby, they fail to maximize digitalization. They cannot explore what doesn't concern them. You, when they are with their phone, when they are doing anything online, you know that it's what concerns them that they are facing. Now, they should be the most active, but unfortunately, they are not. You understand? Then they, they underuse digitalization. What should these people have? They should have blogs, they should have websites. These people should have blogs and they should have websites. Then we have the, so if you are in this category, you should have a blog in your name. You should have a website for your company. And of course, we now have the digital alias. These people are in their 56 to 80. Usually they are not interested in anything digital. You see that they be, some of them believe it's Antichrist. They will tell you, ah, no, it's wrong. Some will say it's for younger generation, it's a myth, and they believe it's insecure. But you know the funny thing? These people are highly needed, highly needed. Their experience, highly needed in digitalization, through blogs. They need to have blogs, and that is something that will help them to pour their experiences to us. Then, of course, you find old, I use that consciously, religious leaders, aged academicians, and aged illiterates or traders. They are the ones usually in this category. They are digital aliens. They don't want it at all. Now, categories of digital workers. Of course, we have the unemployed. Most of us are not there. If you are unemployed, learn programming. That's what I tell them. Learn programming and begin to, you don't need any other job. Face this thing, you'll make it. Career worker, that's where most of us belong. And I will dwell here for some time. When you are a career worker, let me pick a lecturer, for example. You come in as a GA, deep within you. Once you come in as a GA, you are not applying for any other job again. You are thinking of, I want to be a chief lecturer in the polytechnic. I want to be a professor in the university. That's a career worker. You come in and in admin, and you are in the accounting section. I want to be the chief accountant. I want to be the bosser. That's a career worker. Such people, they are natural content carriers because of their career. Because of the career you have, you are a carrier of content. You are a content carrier because of your career. Are you getting it? Please, can you someone help me write content carrier? I want to see you write it. Thank you. Because 99% of you here, you are content carriers. Content carriers, you have something that people want to hear from you. You have spent 10 years in a particular job. And of course, those who are just spending a year, they want to know about your experience. How do you tell them? That's the function of blog. That's digitalization. You understand? They want to learn from you. You are a gifted counselor. You are a gifted organizer. Yes, someone has typed that. Right? Quickly say, yes, content carrier. Thank you. Content carrier. Content carrier. Thank you so much, Starunke. Content carrier. Do you understand? So they are content carriers because of the career they have. These people have to, you can write about your career, you can become great, daring. That's what we are talking about. But you can only do this through blogs. You must have a blog in your name, www.musibaolatif.com. You understand? That's what we are talking about. www.dipoalani.com. www.oyekachi.com. That's what content carrier. You understand? So you look at it, you look at your name, your Taiwo, TaiwoKolawole.com, OlaideolaTunji.com. That is a content carrier. That's something you need to understand. That's digitalization. Selling your content to the country, having your content from the account and taking it to the country. That's digitalization. And another issue is so when you talk about content carriers, also it applies. Maybe you're a religious person and you want to teach about your religion. It's a content. You need a blog. That's digitalization. You understand? Another thing is that someone like me who is a life coach, I teach on personal development. If you read my last post, I was talking about finance and the rest. I mean, you write about it. Oh, there's something trendy, you write about it. My senior friend there, write about legal writing. That is digitalization. You get into that world. Business owners, of course, you need website. If you run a business, you need a website. You cannot but have a website. Now, what are the advantages of digitalization? Oh, it will give you digital presence. And that's something key. We're learning this on Sunday. The contact channels with customers. The customers are the heart of the business. Then you help make better decisions. That's something. that you need to understand. It will help you to make better decisions. A lot of people don't understand this aspect. When you have digitalization, you see that instead of you taking decision and you say, I was lucky. You don't need to do that. Everything will be digitalized and all the analysis will be given to you. So it will help you to take better decision. It encourages innovation. Wow. Look at what we're having today. Myself and someone here, Engineer Alani, we are already putting up a training for retirees. You understand? And can you imagine? That training will be holding on Sunday, maybe around 4 p.m. or thereabout. You understand? For retirees. That's an innovation. It's an innovation. It's not been done before, at least not in the state. I've not even seen it being done online for in the country. And of course, I'm the first to do that. It's an innovation. This time, sure, we encourage innovation. I'm going to meet all of them by 4 p.m. We post out the house, maybe tonight or very early tomorrow morning, by our designer. Are you getting the idea now? So by the time the poster comes out, you see that it helps you. It's an innovation. It's a new way of doing things, reaching them, blessing the people. It makes communication and teamwork easier. What did I do to get the retirees together? The only person I know there is the person who is there. Oh yeah, engineer, help me get your people. He said, no problem. I created a WhatsApp group. I made them admin. Before I knew what was happening, we were almost 20 there. Once we make the poster, and we say retirees should register. It's free. I'm saying retirees, yes, but they should, we invite them. And it goes rap. You see that everybody will say, wow, this is good. This is nice. Do you understand? And they will join. Then the training we hold. We do the first training. Then we have the major one, maybe by next week or upper. That is how it goes. That is how it goes. So let us improve. It improves working condition. Of course, look at it now. I'm working from home. I'm working from home. You're at home. You're in class. If your child calls and says, no, don't disturb me. I'm in class. That's digitalization. Now let's look at digital opportunities. Now the digital opportunities that we have available to us, online full employment. If you're unemployed, go for it. Now if you are very good, you are writing, of course, some companies pay editors. Some pay for content development. You're able to write for them, they'll pay you. Website blog management. These are things, engineer learning, these are things retirees can easily do. Someone who has been PS, who has been in the ministry for 30 years writing, and says he's not retiring anywhere. He still has a lot of stuff to do. Some people want to pay them. They will be patient to go through the write-up. They will be paid. There are people who are doing this. You should be mindful of how your lifetime goes with change as you get older. Can you see that, sir? You understand? So that's exactly what I'm talking of. Then, of course, you have e-commerce. You can sell online, buy online, and that's something you have to do. In fact, this thing is even what a lot of people who are in their old ages, their 60s and the rest, they should get involved with the more, because they will not even be interested in playing any games. It goes straight to what they want to do and they get their results. So, of course, I can have online training. You can train anybody. If you are good at kitchen works, you can train people how to cook a particular type of meal through digitalization online, and they will pay you. If you go on Facebook, you'll see a lot of things. Someone will tell you to learn how to cook coconut rice or fada rice. By the time they are done, they will tell you 1,000. 50 people registers. You know what it means. Do you understand? That's how it goes, because it gets to the world. You reach the world. It's without boundary. I told you I've trained people from Dubai. I've trained people from Canada. The class I held yesterday, people from Canada were there in blogging class. Do you understand? I've trained people from the north. You are from different states. Do you understand? So that is how it goes, digitalization. Online training, everybody. You can train everybody. Even that thing you have that a lot of people need. My senior friends, you discover that even in the digital world, a lot of people, the politicians, a lot of them need something on legal drafting. And you know what that means. And legal drafting is key to anybody. You can train, you can organize a free training for all speakers in Nigeria. They will log in on legal drafting. You just organize the 30 minutes, 1 hour, you speak to them free. The next time they'll be asking for money, they're going to be paying. You train everybody. You train anybody. That's how it goes. You can, your students, you can hold this for them. your PhD students, your MSc students, mature students, they will come online, they will get all these things done. We can't waste our talents. We can't waste the resources. I have been asking a lot of people that you check yourself, your resources and your results, are they commensurate? When your resources is not commensurate with your results, that means you have to move from the level of effectiveness to efficiency. You have to move. I want the admin to help me put that in a write-up. You understand? You have to move. When your resources is not commensurate to your results, you just have to move from effectiveness to efficiency. And that's what I'm talking about. With all you have, when you have digitalization, you are there. That's what I discovered. I don't need to rush anywhere again. I'm gifted. I can communicate. Thank you. That's a very short break. So you understand. So you have online training and you have that. Apart from that, you can hold counseling, human capacity development, all those things you can do them through your blog. You write, you counsel people, you do all those things. They are there. That doesn't stop there. Another thing now is social media marketing. Wow, this is important for the younger generation. Even for the adults, you drive the social media. You have email marketing, you have LinkedIn marketing. You know, we have LinkedIn marketing, we have email marketing, we have Facebook marketing. Yeah, and this will be paid. I wish the elderly ones can understand some of these things. You can be a search engine optimization expert. And of course, you have voiceover artists. This is another green area in the digital world that is making a lot and lot of money. Look at some digital opportunities here. Look at this person. I just brought this for you to see. If you want to bring video on that person's page, you collect 10,000. If you want to bring poster, 30,000. Twitter, 30,000. Twitter advert, 30,000 per month. But look at what someone is making. Now, we lecturers, you know, it's very funny. Someone will tell you for 500 followers, I'll give you 30,000. And you know how many students you have in 100 level? How many? 200, 300, 400, 500. Someone is now promising you 500 followers. And what will he give you? Will give you their email. It's not as if he's bringing them to your house. Can you imagine? So that's what we're... That's exactly what we are talking about. So now, to move on, you now see the next is digital expression. How do you express yourself in the digital world? Digital communicators must find ways to express thoughts and ideas, both clearly and concisely. Text in a plain environment. This is when you want to express yourself. Emojis, that's emoticons. You understand that we have a class for that, but it's not part of your class. So you have voice notes. That's what I did today. You have video. Video is heavy, but what we are doing now it's a video. Yes, it requires more data, but of course it's a very good platform of communication. You are looking at me. You can understand my expression and what have you. Then we have graphics. Graphics application on mobile phone is the main mode of digital expression, graphics. And of course, I want to assure you that by this time on Sunday, you'll have become graphics expert, depending on how much of your assignment you do. And of course, that will determine your result. So what else? We are rounding up very shortly. Digital platforms for expression. Oh, how do you express yourself? Two blogs, www.yourname.com. www.dikwalani.com, www.ronkeolurayi.com, you understand, www.shegunaluko.com. Your name, that's the expression, that's what we are talking about. You understand, you have to express them. If you have a business, you need a website. For your company, for your schools, you need a website. Then when you have graphics, but the moment this program is over, I don't expect you to start telling someone happy birthday again verbally. You design, you collect the person's picture, you design it, and you put cut to your name. That's what happens. That's digitalization. Your expression is through graphics. When everybody is saying Happy New Month with their write-up, you bring up your own design. That's digitalization. And that's part of what you're going to be learning in this class. Now, the digital world should give you digital wealth. And how do you get that? Who am I? You have to know who you are. One, your identity. That's a pre-class activity that you were given. Then education, your professional platform. You have a BSc, LLB, LLM, MSc, PhD, you're a professor. That's your professional platform. You're an engineer, you're an accountant, you're a nurse, you're a doctor, medical doctor, whatever, it's your professional platform, and the only thing that one does is to take care of your daily needs. However, you want wealth, it's your strength. Your wealth is in your strength, your potentials. It's not in your salary. Wealth is in strength, not in salary, your potentials. Wealth is in your strength, not in your salary, your potentials. And that's where you have to now know it. My potential, my profession is lecturing. I'm an academician. My potential is this communication. I can design things. You understand? I can write, but I just discovered I have so many of them. You understand? I can write, I can design blogs, design websites. Then I can speak, I can communicate. That's my strength. And that's what I need to build. I now need to build the skills so that my wealth level. So your strength is your natural gifting. It's your natural gifting. But your skills, wow. You need to look at your skills, develop it, grow your skills. And of course, I know you will have a lot of testimonies today. Now, the D's of digitalization, what are the important? What are the D's? One, you discover your needs. You have to discover your needs, the needs in the area. You know, what led to this class is because I've discovered the needs in the digital world. I discovered that a lot of adults don't understand that digitalization is meant for them. They thought it's meant for the kids. And that's why a lot of adults are not involved. So I discovered that. And of course, I keyed into it. And that's why I designed this program. And that's why you are here. Do you understand? You discover the need. You design the solution. You understand? You design the solution. The digitalization. What's the need? I discovered that a lot of retirees are not doing what they should do. They are not getting the result they should get. So I have discovered that. Then I designed the solution. Then what are the skills that are needed to communicate, to do this, to do that? You are the one who will develop your skills. You will grow your skills. It's very, very important. After that, you demonstrate yourself. And of course, that's what I'm doing. Of course, I've even done this severally, demonstrated myself. Now I am distributing myself. And that's why you are paying. What I'm doing for the retirees now is demonstrating myself. I'm telling them, I come for free. But the moment I've structured my package, then I begin to distribute. When you distribute, you have people paying you. You understand? Those are the things that are needed in the digital world. Now, the assignment I'm going to give you is the digitalization, apply it practically to yourself. You apply practically to a particular problem, to a particular thing, and you get it. Thank you so much for listening to the class today. I'm very grateful. God bless you.